बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। आई एम मिसेस नादिया रऊफ फ्रॉम केमिस्ट्री डिपार्टमेंट, आर्मी बर्न हॉल गर्ल्स कॉलेज, अहमदाबाद। एंड टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग फिफ्थ लेक्चर ऑफ हाइड्रोकार्बन्स। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी वर स्टडिंग अबाउट द रिएक्शंस ऑफ अल्कीन्स एंड वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट टू ऑफ द रिएक्शंस। नाउ टुडे वी विल बी स्टडिंग रेस्ट ऑफ द रिएक्शंस ऑफ अल्कीन्स। So in today's lecture we will be discussing in detail the reactions and their mechanisms as well, the reactions that were left over in the previous lecture. We are going to study about hydration, we will be studying about halogenation of alkenes, we will be studying about halohydration, we will be studying about epoxidation, ozonolysis and polymerization of alkenes in detail. So let's start with hydration first. What is meant by hydration? Hydration means addition of water into anything. As alkenes, we know these are organic compounds, and organic compounds are usually not soluble in water. So how they are going to react with water? They won't be reacting. There are very less few alkenes that are soluble in water. Most of the alkenes are not soluble in water. They will react with the water in the presence of some suitable reagent. In this reaction, the reagent utilized is sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid will be utilized, that is going to add hydrogen and hydroxyl of water into alkene molecule. This is the simplest reaction that can be shown. Alkene molecule can react with water in the presence of H positive. H positive means this is the proton that is coming from acid. Do remember there are double arrows, which means reaction is reversible. And of course hydrogen ions and hydroxyl ions will be produced from water. Hydrogen ions and hydroxyl ions will be added. This double bond will be broken up and they will be added up with the carbon atoms according to Markovnikov's rule, and alcohol would be produced. This reaction is opposite to the preparation, to the reaction that you have studied in the preparation of alkene. You have studied about dehydration of alcohols that was carried out to produce alkene. But right now we are using the opposite reaction. We will be adding up water and we will be producing alcohol according to Markovnikov's rule. The reaction conditions for this one, all of the reactions are very important, girls, and they have to be mentioned. It is very important for you to mention all of the conditions that are required. Catalyst that is utilized for this reaction is sulfuric acid, and this reaction occurs at almost temperature of 100 degree centigrade, that is the temperature of steam. So in fact water and sulfuric acid are added together when temperature is very high, that is almost at 100 degree centigrade. First of all, alkene is going to react with sulfuric acid. It is going to make a transition state compound that will later on react with the steam at 100 degree centigrade to produce an alcohol. This is a general reaction that is shown to you. Now let's move on towards mechanism of this reaction. In this reaction, first of all, this is any alkene can be taken. It is going to react with sulfuric acid. This is structure of sulfuric acid that is shown, which has got two hydrogens, and there is rest of the molecule is sulfate ion, SO4 negative 2. There are two hydrogen ions that can be separated from this acid. It is a strong acid, so it can donate its proton to anything. The red hydrogen is proton that will be donated, or that will be detached from the sulfuric acid. As you can see the half arrow. Half arrow means electron is being taken away by oxygen because it is more electronegative, and hydrogen will be in the form of proton or electron deficient species. Now this electron deficient species is in search of electrons, which will be provided to it by alkene, as we have got the pi bond which is present above and below. There is a lot of electron charge density above and below, so it can be donated to this proton and this bond will be broken up. Water is present in this reaction, but it is going to react in the later on state. So what will happen? First of all, this rest of the species, which is called bisulfate ion, HSO4 negative 1, that will be produced, and this proton will be attached with the carbon atom. Now I told you addition will be Markovnikov's addition according to Markovnikov's rule. So hydrogen should be attached with the carbon atom which is already holding more hydrogen. So this is the hydrogen from the acid that has been attached. Now how it has been attached, the electrons were provided by the double bond which was present. So this carbon atom, now both of the electrons has been utilized in making bond with the hydrogen atom. So this carbon atom will be rendered electron deficient species and it will be converted to positive ion or carbocation will be produced. This carbon will develop a positive charge. Now this positive charge will be attacked by another water molecule, or in fact the water molecule which was present here and it was not reacting initially, but it is going to react now. And because oxygen has got electron pairs upon itself and it is a electron rich species, we can say, so now this electron rich species can come and it can attack this carbocation. When it will be attacking a carbocation, this water molecule will be attached with this carbon atom now, and oxygen will develop a positive charge because oxygen has got now developed more bonds as compared to its own capacity. Anything that makes bonds more than its capacity will develop a positive charge. Now oxygen can make only 2 bonds. Right now it has donated its electron pair to the carbocation, so oxygen will develop a positive charge and it will be attached over here with this carbon atom. Now this bisulfatine, this is the leftover structure of bisulfatine having a negative charge. What it is going to do, now this positive charge should be balanced. So what will happen, it is going to take away one of the proton from the water, and as it is acting as a catalyst, so it is going to regain its hydrogen. Now this hydrogen is not the one that was present initially. That initial hydrogen has been given to the carbon atom, to the alkene, and this sulfuric acid will be regenerated because it is acting as a catalyst. What you will be left behind over here with this carbon, there will be just OH group left behind and the structure will be stabilized. Now you can see this is hydrogen attached with one of the carbon according to Markovnikov's rule, and there is hydroxyl attached at another end in the presence of sulfuric acid, and alcohol will be produced in the reaction. This second step, that is attack of water on carbocation, will occur at 100 degree centigrade, that is at steaming temperature. Now moving on towards next reaction, which is halogenation. As you know, addition of any halogen to alkene would be called halogenation. For example, this is a double bond. Halogen can be any bromine, chlorine, fluorine, and iodine are usually not utilized because fluorine reactions are too violent to control and iodine is too slow to react. So that's why we utilize either chlorine or bromine. Among these two, bromine is very good reagent for the reaction. In this case, double bond will be broken up. This halogen bond will also be broken up, and one of the halogen will be added up with one carbon and other will be added up with two carbon, resulting in the production of vicinal dihalide. Vicinal dihalide means a dihalide having two halogens attached at adjacent positions in a chain would be called a vicinal dihalide. If it is present at position number 1 and one of them, other one is present at 4, 5 or 6, it won't be called vicinal dihalide. It would be called geminal dihalide in that case. So vicinal dihalide would be produced. The reaction catalyst is CCl4, carbon tetrachloride would be utilized. Product produced is vicinal dihalide, and intermediate is the bromonium ion that would be produced. It is a very important step. We are going to study about it in the mechanism. Mechanism of the reaction is, first of all, this is alkene molecule which is being shown. This is the double bond. The halogen molecule will undergo heterolytic cleavage. Heterolytic cleavage means when it will come near alkene molecule, it will be polarized. Otherwise, it is not a polar compound. It will have the electronic pair existing between two of the bromine atoms. But when it will come near to alkene, because alkene also has got electronic cloud above and below in the form of a pi bond, So it is going to disturb the electronic distribution in this bromine molecule, and bromine, one of the bromine will take both of the electrons, will attract both of the electrons towards itself, resulting in a partial negative charge upon it, and other one will become partially positively charged. Now the bond, this double bond will be broken up and bromine will be attached with the alkene molecule. This is how bromine will be attached. One of the bromine, which was positively charged, is now attached with the carbon atom. And it is, because it is positively charged, it is being attacked. It is being attached with both of the carbon atoms, making a cyclic bromoniamine. This is the bromoniamine that has been produced, in which bromine is present in a form of a cyclic structure and having a positive charge upon it. Now the next bromide ion, this is positively charged bromoniamine, and negatively charged is the bromidine. Bromidine is going to attack it from the other side, because bromine is itself a large molecule, a large atom. So the next bromine cannot attack it from the same side. It is going to attack this molecule from the other side. And in that case, it will be attached with the other carbon atom. And this is how a vicinal dihalide would be produced. This reaction is a very important reaction. It is utilized to detect double bond in a molecule. Bromine liquid is, when you will go in the labs, you are going to perform this test as well. You will be given some alkanes and alkenes. Both of them are colorless. You are going to add brown color bromine water into it. You will see alkanes. In alkanes, it is going not going to react. But in alkenes, the color of bromine, that is brown in color, it will be discharged. And that will show the presence of alkenes molecule. So it is used to detect double bond in a molecule. Now let me explain the mechanism in a better picture, in which orbitals are also being shown to you people for your better understanding. This is an alkene molecule and this is a bromine molecule, which is undergoing a heterolytic cleavage when it comes near alkene molecule. This is a ethene molecule. These are CH2 and CH2. They won't be CH3, CH3. They have mistakenly written as that. There is some typing mistake. This electron, pi electronic cloud, which is present above and below, it is going to attack and it is going to make this bromine molecule undergo heterolytic cleavage. And bromine is attached with one of the carbon atom through electronic cloud. Both of the electrons are utilized for the bonding. Now this electronic cloud, this carbocation, positive charge will develop upon the carbon atom and its p orbital will be vacant now, because both of the electrons has been utilized for the bonding. So this bromine is now having excess of electrons upon itself. So with these electrons, it is going to make bond with this empty orbital as well. And a cyclic bromonium ion will be produced. This cyclic bromonium ion will later on add this bromide ion in the anti-addition. Anti-addition means addition from the opposite side, not from the same side. And a vicinal dibromide will be produced in this case. The next reaction in today's lecture is halohydration. The term halohydration means addition of hypohaloic acid to alkene double bond. This, what is this hypohaloic acid? It is HOX. There is a hydroxyl ion attached with the halogen. We have already studied about addition of hydrogen halide. That was the first or the second reaction, which was following the Markovnikov's rule. Now this is not HX, this is HOX. In these two, hydroxyl is much more electronegative as compared to halogen. So hydroxyl will have a negative charge and halogen will have a positive charge in hypohaloic acid. Hypohaloic acids are very reactive acids. They usually do not exist in the form of a reagent. They have to be produced within a reaction. So they cannot be poured in the test tube like simple reagents are reacted together. They will have to be produced within a reaction by some other two chemicals, by combining other two chemicals. The reaction, general reaction for halohydration is alkenes are reacted with halogens. Halogens can be iodine, bromine or taurine in the presence of water. When simply halogens will react, they will react and they are going to produce vicinal dihalides. But in the presence of water, hypohaloic acid will be produced and that will be added up with the in the double bond, and the resultant molecule And the product produced is called halohydrin in this case. This product is called halohydrin. In this reaction, the reaction requirements are halogen reacts in the presence of water, or you can simply call it HOX because it is produced by these two. It is not reacting on its own. The product produced is called halohydrin. Example, this was the general reaction. Any ethene molecule can react with chlorine in the presence of water. Chlorine will be attached with one of the carbon and hydroxyl will be attached with the other carbon, making chlorohydrin. This is a chlorohydrin that has been produced in the reaction. Mechanism of this reaction is almost same as was for halogenation, in which bromonium intermediate ion was produced. In this case, even the same thing will happen. Reaction with the bromine is going to produce, first of all, a bromonium ion. As you can see here, bromine is heterolytic cleavage will be done, and one of the bromine will be attached with the double bond, making a bromonium ion. Bromonium ion in the second step will be attacked by the water from the backside. In halogenation, other bromide ion was attacking it from the other side. But right now, water is going to attack it from the other side. This bromonium ion will be attacked by water. First of all, full water molecule through its lone pair of electron will be attached with the carbon atom, which has rendered a positive charge, which has developed a positive charge of carbocation. And then in the second step, because this hydrogen will be removed by deprotonation will be done, means removal of proton will be done from this water molecule in the form of HBr. This water molecule, this hydrogen, will be taken up by the another molecule of water, and it will be changed into hydronium ion, which will later on react with the bromine to produce HBr. And you can see now hydroxyl is left over here. This is a halohydrin that has been produced in this process. Moving on towards next reaction from today's topic, that is epoxidation. Formation of epoxide or oxirane is called epoxidation. Oxirane is the common name of epoxide. What is an epoxide? This is the epoxide that is being shown to you. In this example, you can see there is a ethene molecule double bond. When it is broken up, there develops a bridging kind of oxygen, which is present in the form of bridge upon two of the carbon atom. So this compound is called epoxide. It is, you can see, when you recall from your functional group, do you remember that you had studied about a functional group called ether, in which oxygen was present in the center and it was attached with two alkyl groups? So isn't it like that? It is almost like that, but the difference is only that alkyl groups are attached to each other as well. So we can simply call it is a three-membered cyclic ether. In epoxidation reaction, the catalyst utilized is CHCl3, and the requirement is per acids are required for this reaction to occur. What is meant by per acid? You know about acids, but you don't know what are per acids. Per acid is the compound, is the acid which contains acidic OOH group. For example, you are familiar with acetic acid CH3COOH. There are two oxygens and one hydrogen. But in peracetic acid, there will be one extra hydrogen present as well. That's why it is called peracetic acid, or general name of this class is called peracid. You are familiar with hydrogen peroxide, I hope. Hydrogen peroxide has got formula of H2O2. That means there are two oxygens and there are two hydrogens. So same is the case with these peracetic acid or per acids. They have got one extra oxygen in them. The general reaction of epoxidation is shown here. The extra oxygen is shown in the colored pink color so that you can see where it is going. Alkenes would react with peroxy acids, and epoxide will be produced. This oxygen will be attached, this double bond will be broken up, and oxygen atom will be attached with the carbon atoms, and it will be making an epoxide, that is oxirane. And along with that, rest of the compound will remain the same. Rest of the compound will be regenerated, or it will be producing a byproduct, which will be now simple organic acid. Right. For example, we have got this alkene. Simple reaction was shown. Now there is a propene present, and this is reacting with perbenzoic acid in the presence of CHCl3. This is perbenzoic acid. This is a benzene ring. If COOH is attached, that is called benzoic acid. If COOH OA, OH, there are three oxygens now. So it will be perbenzoic acid. Now this one of the extra oxygen will be detached and it will be attached with the alkene portion where double bond is present, and epoxy, we are going to call it epoxy propane, and along with that benzoic acid will be regenerated in this reaction. Mechanism of this reaction is not discussed in your book, so you don't need to go into details of this mechanism. Moving on towards next topic from this section, that is ozonolysis. Ozonolysis means reaction of alkene with ozone. Alkenes will react in the presence of ozone and any reducing agent to produce either aldehydes, ketones or carboxylic acids in this case. Some common reducing agents can be zinc in H2O2, or it can be dimethyl sulfide. Requirements for the reaction are, as you know, this is ozone that is required, and any reducing agent can be utilized, that is zinc or dimethyl sulfide. Intermediate produced is molozonide, that you are going to see in the mechanism later on, and the products of this reaction are aldehyde, ketones, or along with that carboxylic acid can be produced. This is a very important reaction which is used to locate position of double bond in an alkene. We have studied about bromination before this, that was used to detect whether double bond is present in the compound or not. But right now, this ozonolysis among various alkenes, if you want to know where is the double bond present, is it present in the center of the chain, or it is present at the terminal end, or it is present at position 2 or 3 or 4, you can use this reaction for this purpose. You will get to know where double bond was located. Let's see mechanism of this reaction. Girls, mechanism of this reaction is very important, so please pay attention, okay? First of all, ozone molecule, this is structure of ozone. There are three oxygen atoms which are linked together, and there are in fact double bond between any two of the oxygen, and there is a single bond between any two of the oxygen. This double bond can be present here, and this single bond can be present here as well. This oxygen, because it is making only one bond, so it will develop a partial negative charge because of excess of electrons. And this oxygen, you can see, is making three bonds. And as I told you previously, it is going to develop a positive charge because it is making more bonds than its own capacity. That will be neutral. This oxygen will be simply neutral one. When it will come near alkene molecule, now this is a charged species, right? So it will be reactive enough as well. So when it is going to come near the alkene molecule, double bond of alkene will be broken up. You can see the direction of arrows. This is very important. Do not ever put the random arrows, okay? You always have to point arrows from the point, from the starting point and towards the ending point. Not random arrows are not allowed. So you can see this negative charge is going to make, when this will be broken up, this bond will be broken up, this negative charge is going to make bond between carbon and oxygen. This double bond will be broken up and electrons will be utilized to make the bond between this carbon and this oxygen. And this double bond will also be broken up because oxygen cannot make this much bonds. So when this will be broken up, this positive charge will be neutralized due to these electrons. So what will happen, this whole molecule will be attached at the top of alkene molecule by breaking the double bond of alkene. And this whole structure is called molozonoid. Molozonoid is a very, very reactive intermediate, that is a short-lived species produced for a very short period of time, and it is very reactive. It will be converted into another short-lived species, that is ozonoid. Now, how molozonoid is converted to ozonoid? By first of all breaking into small fragments or small pieces. How it will be broken up into small pieces? First of all, these two pieces will be separated from the molecule, that is this bond will be broken up and this bond will be broken up, and of course carbon and oxygen will develop a double bond between each other. So this fragment has been separated and rest of the molecule will be separated. When there is a these electrons will be utilized to make bond between carbon and oxygen. Now this oxygen will develop a positive charge and this oxygen will develop a negative charge due to excess of electrons. Now these two fragments will join together in a little bit different orientation than they were present before, and they will be converted into ozonoid. How? This molecule will turn itself in this way, and you will see negatively charged oxygen is going to attach itself with the carbon. This double bond will be broken and oxygen will be attached with this carbon. Again, this double bond will be broken, that will be utilized to neutralize the positive charge on oxygen atom. Now again they are present in the form of a cycle, but now all three oxygens are not present together. One of the oxygen is lying between two of the carbon atom and other two are lying here. This is ozonoid. Now ozonoid will be reacted with the methyl disulfide, any reducing agent, or zinc and water can also be taken. In this way, what will happen, when it will be treated with dimethyl sulfide or with water, one of the oxygen which was present here, it will be taken away by water or reducing agent, that is dimethyl sulfide, and molecule will be again broken up into two small pieces. See this molecule, the movement of the cursor please. This molecule will be separated and this molecule will be separated. This bond and this bond will be broken up and this bond will also be broken up. So a double bond between carbon and oxygen will develop. Double bond between carbon and oxygen will be developed. And you will see these two carbon atom, carbon and oxygen. You can see these two carbon and oxygen. Both of them will now develop a positive double bond between carbon and oxygen and they will be the same molecules. So a carbonyl product will be produced, which can be either aldehyde depending upon the attachments which are present with these two carbon with the carbon atoms, or it can be two alkyl groups attached, so again it will be a ketone, or it can be one alkyl group and another hydroxyl group, so it can be a acid as well, carboxylic acid as well. This was the case when a symmetrical alkene was present. Both of the sides of double bond were the same. Carbon atom had the same environment. Now moving on towards the unsymmetrical kind of alkenes. If for example we have got an unsymmetrical alkene, what would happen? What would be the product? The reaction mechanism will be the same. The only difference is you can see R1, R2 and R3 and hydrogen. There are four different groups that are being attached here. It will attack in the same way. Ozone is going to attack it. Double bond will be broken up. First of all, molozonoid will be prepared, which will later on be broken up from one of the sides, and you would see this bond is broken up. Double bond developed between oxygen and atoms and negative charge appears over here, and this bond will be broken up. It will be converted to two fragments that will later on join to make ozonoid, in which oxygen is present. One of the oxygen is present between the carbon atom. Now the linkage between carbon atoms has been broken up. Now when these two fragments will join together, you will see ozonoid will be produced, and ozonoid will later on in the presence of H2O2 will be broken up. This bond will be broken up from here and one of the bond will be broken up from here between two oxygen atoms. This bond, when it is broken up, this carbon and oxygen will develop a double bond making a ketone right now, and this bond will be broken up as well. So double bond will be generated between this carbon and this carbon oxygen. When there is a double bond here, there is bond over here, three bonds, then there is a fourth bond and fifth bond cannot be there. So what would happen? This hydrogen bond will be broken up and hydrogen will be attached with oxygen later on. This bond has already been broken up, so it will be converted to OH. So this resultant molecule will have R3 carbon linked with double bond OOH. It is a carboxylic acid that will be produced. In case of unsymmetrical alkenes, you would see a ketone and carboxylic acid will be produced. This reaction is very important, ozonolysis, and its mechanism is also very important. Moving on towards next reaction, which is polymerization. As you know about polymerization means a combination of small monomers to form a long chain structure, which is called polymer, and this process is called polymerization. Alkenes can undergo polymerization through various mechanisms, but we are not discussing mechanisms right now, into long chain molecules. For example, N stands for various lot many ethene molecules can join together. Their double bonds will be broken up and various molecules will start linking to each other. So polyethene will be produced, which is simply called polythene, polythene choppers, polythene bags that we are using. It is polyethene in fact. And there are various alkenes molecules which are joining together. In this reaction, catalyst utilized is small traces of oxygen, almost 0.1% oxygen is utilized as a catalyst. Temperature is 400 degrees centigrade and pressure of 100 atmosphere is utilized. This is, do remember, this is addition polymerization, means a lot many molecules are added together to make a long chain structure. There are various kinds of polymerization, among which we are studying addition polymerization when we talk about alkenes. This is the simplest structure of polyethene was told to you. There can be some other examples regarding polymerization of alkenes. For example, we can have substituted alkenes as well. If we are having a tetrafluoroethene instead of hydrogen, there are four fluorines attached. Various molecules can join together. Double bonds will be broken up. All thousands of molecules can join together to make up polytetrafluoroethene molecule. Polytetrafluoroethane in fact, and it is usually called Teflon. Teflon is utilized in various kind of plastics, you have heard about it. Similarly, we can have a chloroethene as well. If it is chlorine attached at one of the position, double bond can be broken up, various molecules can join together and they can make a lot of molecules can combine together to make a long chain structure that is polymer. This is called polychloroethene. And it is also called PVC, polyvinyl chlorine. This is also a common name for this one. PVC is also a kind of plastic that is utilized for making various household articles and pipes, etc. So these were reactions of alkenes. We have studied about numerous reactions. These were all that we have studied. Girls, reactions are all very important. Let me tell you some important tips for memorizing and writing reactions, which is important. First of all, practice these reactions too many times, at least 2 to 3 times. By writing the reactions on your copies, they cannot be memorized in any other possible way. You always have to write reactions. Secondly, whenever you are writing a reaction in examination, you always have to write a balanced equation. If the equation is not balanced, marks will not be awarded to you. The name of reactants and products should be mentioned below the reaction, below the reactant or below the product. And the most important thing is the catalyst and the reaction conditions, temperature, pressure. That this is the reason I have mentioned them separately with every reaction, so that you can memorize them as well. This is very important point. Okay, practice all these reactions at your homes and let me know if you are facing any trouble anywhere. That's all for today. Thank you very much. Allah Hafiz.